A very hearty welcome to this new episode of Spell Talk, the program based on tricky spelling. Today, we can see the tricky words starting with Z. This is episode number 46, the last episode of Spell Talk. Okay, first we will see the word select. The spelling Z-E-A-L-O-T. The tricky area in the word is the E-A after Z. Now, zealot means a person who is extremely enthusiastic or passionate about something, especially his religion, politics, etc. Now, let us see the word once more, zealot, Z-E-A-L-O-T. Okay, our next word is zeitgeist. The spelling Z-E-I-T-G-E-I-S-T. The tricky areas are the EI after Z and the EI towards the end of the word. Zeitgeist means the spirit of the times, or in other words, the trend of thinking and feeling in a particular period of time. Malayalam, Yuga Chedana. Okay, now let us see that word once more. Zeitgeist. Z-E-I-T. G-E-I-S-T. And our next word now is suffer. The spelling Z-E-P-H-Y-R. The tricky area is the P-H-Y in the middle of the word. Suffer means a mild, gentle wind or a breeze. Malayalam, Mandamarudan. So let us see that word once more, zephyr, Z-E-P-H-Y-R. Now we can consider the word Zionism. The spelling Z-I-O-N-I-S-M. Zionism is a political movement originally for the creation of an independent state for the Jewish community, and now for the development of the state of Israel. So let us see that word once more, Zionism, Z-I-O-N-I-S-M. Now we can consider the word zombie. The spelling Z-O-M-B-I-E. The tricky area in the word is the I-E at the end of the word. Zombie means a person who is partly alive and who has no interest in what is going on or happening around him. So, in some African religions, zombie means a corpse or dead body that has been revived by means of witchcraft. So, let us see that word once more. Zombie, Z-O-M-B-I-E. Now, we can consider the word Zoroastrianism. The spelling Z-O-R-O-A-S-T-R-I-A-N-I-S-M. The tricky area in the word is the O-A after R. Now, Zoroastrianism is a religion that was founded by Zoroaster in the ancient Persian Empire, which is now in Iran. The religion teaches us that there is one God and there is a constant struggle between the forces of light and darkness. But from 16th century onwards, the Zoroastrians had to face inhuman religious persecution, and so some of them escaped into distant lands, especially India. Wherever the Zoroastrian refugees landed, they went on to become the joy of the land. For example, we can consider any field of activity in India, and we can see a Zoroastrian or a Parsi straddling the field like a colossus. For example, take the case of industry. There is no name more hallowed than Tata. Take the case of the military. Field Marshal SHFJ Manekshaw was one of the most highly decorated soldiers in Indian history, and he was our first field marshal. Take the case of law. Nani Palkiwala was a demigod. Take the case of music. Can we imagine a greater celebrity than Zubin Mehta? Another characteristic feature of the Zoroastrians is that they have never been involved in any serious criminal activity like terrorism, treason, extremism, human trafficking, drug trafficking, or fake currency, gold smuggling, or tax evasion, etc. That's why I said, wherever the Zoroastrian refugees landed, they went on to become the joy of the land. Okay, now we can consider another word, Zoolatry. The spelling Z-O-O-L-A-T-R-Y. The tricky area is the T-R-Y at the end of the word. Zoolatry means worship of animals. So let us see that word once more, Zoolatry. Z-O-O-L-A-T-R-Y. Now, we can see the word zucchini. The spelling Z-U-C-C-H-I-N-I. The tricky area in the word is the double C-H in the middle of the word. Zucchini is a long vegetable with a dark green skin and white flesh. So let us see that word once more. Zucchini. Z-U-C-C-H-I-N-I. Now, that leads us to the end of the tricky words, starting with Z. Well, I used to conclude every episode with the words goodbye for the time being. But today, I cannot use the term goodbye for the time being, because today it is goodbye for good, because we have completed 46 episodes and we have come to the end of the program called Spell Talk. Since we have finished it, I would like to say a few words extra today. And first of all, I would like to say a word of thanks to God Almighty, who helped us to bring this program to its logical conclusion. Okay, now this program was the brainchild of Reverend Father Sebastian Menakkeparambil at the bursar of SH College. He took the initiative and provided unstinting support and abundant freedom to carry on with this program. So I would like to use this opportunity to place on record my deep and sincere gratitude to Reverend Father Sebastian Menakkeparambil, and my gratitude is beyond words. Okay, now Reverend Father Anthony Pallathiparambil, the creative head of SH Vision, used to provide the necessary guidance and direction based on his professionalism, prowess, and acumen. So, may I thank Reverend Father Anthony from the very bottom of my heart. Now, I would like to thank Mr. Edwin and his assistant Ajitha for providing state-of-the-art technology and the other paraphernalia needed for the purpose. And last but not least, I owe a debt of gratitude to the loyal viewers of SH Vision for their abiding loyalty, support, and encouragement for this program. So, a big thank you to all of you. Thank you very much indeed.